Hey guys, David Kwan here. So in this video I want to talk about a really cool game, XCom Enemy Unknown. Sadly, it was the last game I was playing before my PS3 decided to catch the infamous Yellow Light of Doom, YLOD, and die on me. So it's still stuck in there in my PS3. It was a Gamefly game, so I was having a lot of fun with it. I was actually deciding to keep it, but now I'm forced to keep it because it's stuck in there. And who knows when I'll repair my PS3. It might be 2 or 3 months down the road. Because right now I don't have the $100 or about $130 because taxes and shipping and handling and stuff that it would take to repair my PS3. So it's going to be stuck in there for a while. But I did have a good run with it. I played XCOM for about 30 hours. I was really addicted to it. And so I had a good run and just want to talk about it. Really, the one thing that I really want to talk about is the enemies in the game, because I think sometimes they're just ridiculously overpowered. And so I just want to talk about what the enemy I think is the most overpowered, and I'll make arguments for that. Before that, though, I mean, this game is quite addictive, and it's really interesting that the reason I think it's so addictive is because it keeps the player so underpowered and so underfunded most of the campaign. That's because the only way to generate income is actually through just waiting, and waiting like 3 months, like 30 days is you get an income at the end of every month, and then just by selling stuff, but you can't sell stuff that much because a lot of them are essential for research, so you can only sell junk, but those junks are rare to come by. Anyway, most of the game, you're underpowered, and underfunded. That's the most important thing, and yeah, it's a tough game. I've tried classic difficulty, which is just hard difficulty. I know there's an even higher difficulty setting after that, but I don't even want to touch that. But classic difficulty, I tried for 2 hours before I kind of rage quit, and I was just like, fuck this difficulty, I'm never playing this difficulty again. I do really like second wave, where you can just modify a little bit, bunch of different things. So that, you know, the game can be a lot more random, a lot more difficult. And I also really, really love Iron Man mode, which makes it so that there's only one save and it's an auto save. So if something bad happens, you can't reload a save like you could normally do without Iron Man mode on. You know, you can't save because it's just that one save. So if a squad mate dies, he or she dies permanently. If you fail a mission, it's not game over. The game continues with that mission failed and with all those people in that mission dead, permanently dead. There's this amazing sense of continuity that carries over that I haven't experienced in any other game of this type. I mean, there's other games that boast this. It's why I love Heavy Rain so much, because of that continuity. A character in that game dies, the story continues with that character dead. You know, it's rare to see, and I love it. I especially love it in this game because it plays so much importance to strategy. Like, now I'm playing with every trick up my sleeve, and I'm trying to play it as cautiously and as intensely as I can, because I know that these characters can die, and once they die, that's it for them. It's one of the most intense experiences I've ever had in gaming. So that's pretty damn awesome. I mean, there's many other things that, you know, I wish could be better with XCOM, but just that alone had me on the edge of my seat, and I thought that was really awesome. But the enemies, though, like, they're super overpowered. Sometimes it just makes me so frustrated and angry. Sometimes I look back at the moments that I had with these enemies and just like, wow, that was so much fun. But there's really just the three main enemy types that are just, holy shit, what the fuck. The first one I want to mention is that robot guy. I forget the name of it, but it's this gigantic mech thingy. It shoots like laser rockets. It's just gigantic. There's nothing else like it in the game, so obviously it's easy to know what I'm talking about. Yeah, that thing is ridiculous. The fact that it has a reaction, it can do like overshoot, just because if somebody comes in within the vicinity of it without using a turn, it can fire on that guy. That itself is damaging enough, but it also acts twice. It fires once and then it acts twice. So it has like two turns, which is ridiculously unfair because its attack can also destroy covers. And this game is all about the cover system. Once a cover is destroyed, that character that was taking cover there is not totally vulnerable and takes like twice or thrice as much damage. And it's like instant death once that happens. This guy is ridiculous. This guy also has the most armor in the game. It takes so many characters, so many turns to take this guy down. So he's definitely like the most armor, the most heavily like armed enemy in the game. Takes a lot of time to take this thing down, but I think it's the third most overpowered because it I've never failed a mission because of this guy. It's usually like I barely survived a mission sometimes, but I've never failed a mission because of this guy. This guy can be taken down with a great amount of teamwork. You just corner the guy or just surround the guy, and it's only one time in the campaign is there two of them at the same time. Every time else, there's only one of this thing. And it always stays in the back, so you can take care of everything else and then take care of it. It doesn't move towards you, it stays in one place. So that's why it's third on my list. The second most overpowered is obviously the enemy leader, the freaking alien leader thingy-majiggy that can control people's minds. And that's the fact that it can control people's mind is what makes it so ridiculous. Because it can control the minds of the highest, the best experienced, my best soldier in the squad. And this happened with that character having a mind shield equipped. That was like, what the heck? Like, this guy, she's a colonel, she's an amazing sniper, she's so far away from the enemy. Not only that, she has a mind shield on, plus she has psychic ability, so she's a psychic soldier. But her mind still gets controlled. Like, what the heck? And, you know, the minute that happens, I just start to panic. Just the fact that it can do that, it has ridiculous amount of health. It can kill weak-willed squad members with like just like that. So it makes it super powerful. It's really tough foe. But I think the most overpowered enemy in the game is Chrysalis, that alien creature thing that attacks with like. It's a weird creature thing. It's the only enemy in the game that doesn't run away when discovered. Every other enemy in the game, once you discover it, there's the fog of war is broken off, and they go into this dance routine. They take cover before you can actually like start moving towards them. This enemy, once discovered, moves towards the squad mates, move towards you. Like, holy crap, that's terrifying. And then you attack it. If it survives and your turn is ended, then it comes towards you and it attacks. It attacks with melee attacks. Has no weapons of any kind other than claws. And in this game, melee attacks do not miss. So no matter what, if this thing attacks and is in your range, you're going to get hurt or you're going to die. Okay, fair enough. That's tough. But then, if your squad mate dies, immediately afterwards, that squad mate turns into a zombie. Holy shit. And that's not enough. This zombie has 10 health units, or 10 health bars, so it's pretty strong. You have to get a critical hit to take it down. But if you don't take this zombie down within 3 turns, that zombie in turn will turn into another one of those creature thingies. I've failed like so many missions because of these chrysalis things, and it's usually those rescue the civilians type missions where you have to make sure that you kill all the enemies, wipe out all the enemies in the map, and the civilians are safe. But then these guys, they go around killing all those civilians, and before you can get to those civilians, they turn into zombies, and before you can get to those zombies, they turn more into them. So, yeah, those guys are just ridiculous. They remind me a lot of the enemies, I don't know why, but for some reason it reminds me of the enemies in Dead Nation. That particular enemy with like gigantic blade as its arms, and they're four-legged too, and they look kind of similar to the ones in XCom. It reminds me a lot of those, and I remember those being, to me, the hardest enemies in Dead Nation. Something about these kind of weird creature thingies that just makes it so terrifying and so rage quit worthy. But yeah, definitely, like, especially in Iron Man mode, like, any mission with them in it, I'm just like, damn it, why did I send my best soldiers to this mission? They're all gonna get slaughtered and die. And that happens, and I'm just like, mission failed, god, I have to level up, like, so many characters all over again because these guys are dead. It's definitely been, one hair-pulling experience after another with these guys, and that's just kind of what I want to talk about.